चैप्टर 9
राजविद्य राजगुह्य योग अतः नवमो अध्याय है द मोस्ट कॉन्फिडेंशियल नॉलेज। श्री भगवानुवाच इदं तुते गुह्यतमं प्रवक्ष्यामि अनसूयवे ज्ञानं विज्ञान सहितं यज्ञात्वा मोक्षयते अशुभात् राजविद्या राजगुह्यं पवित्रं इदं उत्तमं प्रत्यक्षावगमं धर्म्यं सुसुखं कर्तुम अव्ययम् अश्रद्धधानाः पुरुषा धर्मस्या अस्य परंतपा अप्राप्य माम निवर्तन्ते मृत्यु संसार वर्त्मनि मया ततम इदं सर्वं जगत अव्यक्तमूर्तिना मत्स्थानी सर्वभूतानि न चाहं तेष्वस्थितः न च मत्स्थानी भूतानि पश्य मे योगम ऐश्वर्यम् भूतभृन्न च भूतस्थो ममात्मा भूतभावनः यताकाशोस्थितो नित्यं वायुः सर्वत्र गोमहान् तथा सर्वाणि भूतानि मत्स्थानीति उपधारय सर्वभूतानि कौन्तेय प्रकृतिं यान्ति मामिकां कल्पक्षये पुनस्तानि कल्पादो विस्रजाम्यहं प्रकृतिं स्वाम् अवष्टभ्य विस्रजामि पुनः पुनः भूतग्रामं इमं कृत्स्नम् अवशं प्रकृतेर्वसात् न च मां तानि कर्माणि निबध्नन्ति धनञ्जय उदासीनवदासीनम् असक्तं तेषु कर्मसु मयाध्यक्षेण प्रकृतिः सूयते साचराचरम् हेतुनानेन कौन्तेय जगद्विपरिवर्तते अवजानन्ति मां मूढा मानुषीं तनुम् आश्रितं परं भावम् अजानन्तो मम भूतमहेश्वरम् मोघाशा मोघकर्माणो मोघज्ञानविचेतसः राक्षसीम् आसुरीं चैव प्रकृतिं मोहिनीं श्रिताः महात्मानस्तु मां पार्थ दैवीं प्रकृतिम् आश्रिताः भजन्ति अनन्यमनसो ज्ञात्वा भूतादिमव्ययम् सततं कीर्तयन्तो मां यतन्तश्च दृढव्रताः नमश्यन्तश्च मां भक्त्या नित्ययुक्ता उपासते ज्ञानयज्ञेन चाप्यन्ये यजन्तो माम् उपासते एकत्वेन पृथक्त्वेन बहुधा विश्वतो मुखम् अहं क्रतुर् अहं यज्ञः स्वताहम् अहमौषधं मन्त्रोऽहम् अहमेवाज्ञम् अहम् अग्निर् अहं हुतं पिताहम् अस्य जगतो माता दाता पितामह वेद्यं पवित्रम् ओंकार ऋक्सामयजुरेव च गतिर्भर्ता प्रभु साक्षी निवासः शरणं सुहृत् प्रभवति प्रलयस्थानं निधानं बीजमव्ययं तपाम्यहम् अहं वर्षं निघ्रणामि उत्सजामि च अमृतं चैव मृत्युश्च सदसच्चाहमर्जुन त्रैविद्या मां सोमपापूतपापा यज्ञेर इष्ट्वा स्वर्गतिं प्रार्थयन्ते ते पुण्यमासाद्य सुरेन्द्रलोकम् अश्नन्ति दिव्यान् दिविदेव भोगान् ते तं भुक्त्वा स्वर्गलोकं विशालं क्षीणे पुण्ये मर्त्यलोकं विशन्ति एवं त्रयी धर्ममनुप्रपन्ना गतागतं कामकामालभन्ते अनन्याश्चिन्तयन्तो मां ये जनाः पर्युपासते तेषां नित्याभियुक्तानां योगक्षेमं वहाम्यहं ये अपि अन्यदेवता भक्ता यजन्ते श्रद्धयान्विताः ते अपि माम् एव कौन्तेय यजन्ति अविद्धिपूर्वकम् अहं हि सर्वयज्ञानां भोक्ता च प्रभुरेव च न तु माम् अभिजानन्ति तत्त्वेनातश्च वन्दिते यान्ति देवव्रता देवान् पितृन् यान्ति पितृव्रताः भूतानि यान्ति भूतेज्य यान्ति मद्याजिनोऽपि मां पत्रं पुष्पं फलं तोयं यो मे भक्त्या प्रयच्छति तदहं भक्ति उपाहृतं अश्नामि प्रयतात्मनः यत्करोषि यदश्नासि यज्जुहोसि ददासि यत् यत्तपस्यसि कौन्तेय तत्कुरुष्व मदर्पणम् शुभाशुभफलैरेवं मोक्ष्यसे कर्म बन्धनैः संन्यासयोगयुक्तात्मा विमुक्तो माम् उपैष्यसि समोहं सर्वभूतेषु न मे द्वेषोऽस्ति न प्रियः ये भजन्ति तु मां भक्त्या मयि ते तेषु चाप्यहम् अपि चेत् सुदुराचारो भजते माम् अनन्यभाक् साधुरेव स मन्तव्यः सम्यग् व्यवसितो हि सः क्षिप्रं भवति धर्मात्मा शाश्वतशान्तिं निगच्छति कौन्तेय प्रतिजानीहि न मे भक्त प्रणश्यति मां हि पार्थ व्यपाश्रित्य ये अपि स्युपापयोनयः स्त्रियो वैश्यास्तथा शूद्रास्ते अपि यान्ति परां गतिं किं पुनर्ब्राह्मणाः पुण्या भक्ता राजर्षयस्तथा अनित्यम् असुखं लोकम् इमं प्राप्य भजस्व मां मन्मनाभव मद्भक्तो मद्याजी मां नमस्कुरु मामे वैश्यसि युक्त्वैवं आत्मानं मत्परायणः
Translations starting from text 1. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, My dear Arjuna, because you are never envious of me, I shall impart to you this most confidential knowledge and realization, knowing which you shall be relieved of all the miseries of material existence. This knowledge is the king of education, the most secret of all secrets. It is the purest knowledge, and because it gives direct perception of the self by realization, it is the perfection of religion. It is everlasting and it is joyfully performed. Those who are not faithful in this devotional service cannot attain me, O conqueror of enemies. Therefore, they return to the path of birth and death in this material world. By me, in my unmanifested form, this entire universe is pervaded. All beings are in me, but I am not in them. And yet everything that is created does not rest in me. Behold my mystic opulence. Although I am the maintainer of all living entities, and although I am everywhere, I am not a part of this cosmic manifestation. For myself is the very source of creation. Understand that as the mighty wind, blowing everywhere, rests always in the sky, all created beings rest in me. O son of Kunti, at the end of the millennium, all material manifestations enter into my nature, and at the beginning of another millennium, by my potency, I create them again. The whole cosmic order is under me. Under my will, it is automatically manifested again and again, and under my will, it is annihilated at the end. O Dhananjaya, all this work cannot bind me. I am ever detached from all these material activities, seated as though neutral. This material nature, which is one of my energies, is working under my direction, O son of Kunti, producing all moving and non-moving beings. Under its rule, this manifestation is created and annihilated again and again. Fools deride me when I descend in the human form. They do not know my transcendental nature as the Supreme Lord of all that be. Those who are thus bewildered are attracted by demonic and atheistic views. In their deluded condition, their hopes for liberation, their fruitive activities, and their culture of knowledge are all defeated. O son of Pritha, those who are not deluded, the great souls, are under the protection of the divine nature. They are fully engaged in devotional service because they know me as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, original and inexhaustible. Always chanting my glories, endeavoring with great determination, bowing down before me, these great souls perpetually worship me with devotion.
Others who engage in sacrifice with the cultivation of knowledge worship the Supreme Lord as the one without a second, as diverse in many, and in the universal form.
But it is I who am the ritual, I the sacrifice, the offering to the ancestors, the healing herb, the transcendental chant. I am the butter and the fire and the offering. I am the father of this universe, the mother, the support and the grandsire. I am the object of knowledge, the purifier and the syllable Om. I am also the Rig, the Sama and the Yajurvedas. I am the goal, the sustainer, the master, the witness, the abode, the refuge and the most dear friend. I am the creation and the annihilation, the basis of everything, the resting place and the eternal seed. O Arjuna, I give heat and I withhold and send forth the rain. I am immortality and I am also death personified. Both spirit and matter are in me. Those who study the Vedas and drink the Soma juice, seeking the heavenly planets, worship me indirectly. Purified of sinful reactions, they take birth on the pious heavenly planet of Indra, where they enjoy godly delights. When they have thus enjoyed vast heavenly sense pleasure and the results of their pious activities are exhausted, they return to this mortal planet again. Thus, those who seek sense enjoyment by adhering to the principles of the three Vedas achieve only repeated birth and death. But those who always worship me with exclusive devotion, meditating on my transcendental form, to them I carry what they lack and I preserve what they have. Those who are devotees of other gods and who worship them with faith actually worship only me, O son of Kunti, but they do so in a wrong way. I am the only enjoyer and master of all sacrifices. Therefore, those who do not recognize my true transcendental nature fall down. Those who worship the demigods will take birth among the demigods. Those who worship the ancestors go to the ancestors. Those who worship ghosts and spirits will take birth among such beings. And those who worship me will live with me. If one offers me with love and devotion a leaf, a flower, fruit or water, I will accept it. Whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you offer or give away, and whatever austerities you perform, do that, O son of Kunti, as an offering to me. In this way, you will be freed from bondage to work and its auspicious and inauspicious results. With your mind fixed on me, in this principle of renunciation, you will be liberated and come to me. I envy no one, nor am I partial to anyone. I am equal to all. But whoever renders service unto me in devotion is a friend, is in me, and I am also a friend to him. Even if one commits the most abominable action, if he is engaged in devotional service, he is to be considered saintly because he is properly situated in his determination. He quickly becomes righteous and attains lasting peace. O son of Kunti, declare it boldly that my devotee never perishes. O son of Pritha, those who take shelter in me, though they be of lower birth, women, Vaishyas, merchants that is, and Shudras, workers, can attain the supreme destination. How much more this is so of the righteous Brahmanas, the devotees and the saintly kings. Therefore, having come to this temporary, miserable world, engage in loving service unto me. Engage your mind always in thinking of me, become my devotee, offer obeisances to me and worship me, being completely absorbed in me, surely you will come to me. Thus end the Bhaktivedanta translations to the 9th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavad Gita in the matter of the most confidential knowledge.
These are readings from the Bhagavad Gita as it is, with commentaries by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada.
I am Bhakti Vinoda Swami, your servant.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna.